Next is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, third chapter, text number 11, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 17, 1972, in Los Angeles.
Translation: the sixth incarnation of the Purusha was the son of the sage Atri. He was born in the womb of Anasuya, who prayed for an incarnation. He spoke on the subject of transcendence to Alarka, Prahlada, and others, Yadu, Hoihoi, etc. The Lord incarnated Himself as Dattatreya, the son of Rishi Atri and Anasuya. The history of the birth of Dattatreya as an incarnation of the Lord is mentioned in the Brahmanda Purana in connection with the story of the devoted wife. It is said there that Anasuya, the wife of Rishi Atri, prayed before the Lords Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva as follows: "My Lords, if you were pleased with me, and if you desire me to ask from you some sort of blessings, then I pray that you combine together to become my son." This was accepted by the Lords, and as Dattatreya, the Lord expounded the philosophy of the spirit soul, and especially instructed Alarka, Prahlada, Jadu, Hoihoi, etc.
So, here we see that you can have God as your son. There are so many instances that like Devaki, God, Krishna as his son, Mother Yashoda, God as his son, Suchimata, he also got Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as son. So this is better philosophy than to accept God as father. That is especially in the Vaishnava philosophy. Others, the impersonalist, voidist, they have no conception of God. Void is ultimately everything is zero, and the impersonalist, God has no form, and both are the same thing. In a different language, void is, they say, ultimately there is nothing but zero, and the impersonal statement that maybe something, but it is not person, it is impersonal. Therefore, in the Padma Purana, this Buddhist theory, voidism, and the Shankar's theory, impersonalism, they are taken as one and the same. Prachannam Bodham Uchyate. Prachannam Bodham. The Buddhists, they decline to accept the authority of Vedas. And the Mayavadi, the impersonalists, they wanted to accept the authority of Vedas, but under the garb of Buddhism. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given his remark, Vedna maniya bodha hoila nasti. According to Vedic line of thought, anyone who does not accept the authority of Vedas, he is called atheist. Just like the Mohammedans, they also call kafir, one who does not accept the authority of Quran, they call kafir. And the Christians also, they call heathens. So there are different terms. So, according to our Vedic line of thought, anyone who does not accept the Vedic way of life, he is called atheist. Therefore, a Buddhist, according to Vedantis, Buddhists are called atheist. Actually, Buddha philosophy does not accept God, neither soul. They simply philosophize on the material elements. And they want to finish the material, dismantle the material elements, nibbana. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has remarked that the Buddhists are honest. They frankly say that we don't accept your Veda. But the Shankarites, they are cheaters, because they are accepting Vedas but on the basis of Buddha philosophy. That is cheating. So, there are many conceptions of God, but here is a conception of God, to accept God as Son. That is only in Vaishnava philosophy. Because we are eternal servants of God. That is our philosophy. Jive Swarupam Nitya Krishna Das. The living entity, real constitutional position is to serve God. We have several times explained this fact, that a part and parcel of God must be engaged in the service of the Lord. Just like this finger is part and parcel of my body, its duty is to serve the body. It has no other duty. The finger cannot go elsewhere and serve something else. It must serve my body. Therefore it is part and parcel. Similarly, if I am part and parcel of God, then my only duty is to serve God. This is Vaishnava philosophy. So, therefore in Vaishnava philosophy, everything in relationship with God is service. You have seen the picture in our Nectar of Devotion. Krishna's friends, Krishna is resting, they are all engaged in service. Somebody is fanning, somebody is massaging. Although they are friends, there is equality. None of them think that Krishna is greater than them. No. They think Krishna is our friend, a very nice friend, very beautiful friend, and a very powerful friend. Every day they go to the forest and they see one demon is killed by Krishna. So they become very much devoted. Their love for Krishna increased by seeing Krishna's activities, beauty, opulence. Similarly, the gopis, they did not think Krishna is God. They did not know. Even Mother Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj, all the inhabitants of Vrindavan, they did not know, neither they did care to know whether Krishna is God or not. They simply loved Krishna without any identification. We are worshipping God, Krishna, because we are impressed with so many things that Krishna is the Supreme Lord, He is the Absolute Truth. Therefore, we are little inclined, all right, let us serve Krishna, if He is God. You see, there is some condition. Krishna is God, so if I do not love, if I do not worship, then maybe something wrong. So, there is business. But, amongst the gopis and the cowherd boy and the Vrindavan, there is no business. We love Krishna unconditionally, that's all. We do not know anything. except Krishna. This is Vrindavan atmosphere. So, Maharaj Yashoda, Nanda, and other elderly gopis, they used to treat Krishna as son, as beloved son. Because if we accept God as father or mother, there is conception of mother also. The Shaktas, there are many devotees of Durga, Kali, they also accept the mother. The Christian accept as father. The conception of father and mother, that is good. But there is little service. Because children, they take service from the mother and father. They render very little service to the father and mother. Every children, every man, every woman has taken so much services from the father and mother. Everyone knows that. Just like those who are mothers here, how much service they are giving to the little children, how much careful they are that their child may not be in some difficulty, always anxious. Similarly, this philosophy to accept God as son means opportunity for rendering more service than to accept God as father. God is neither father nor his father, actually his father, because he is the origin of everything. Janmadasya jataha. Krishna also says, ahang bija pada pita. Pita means father. So actually God's position is father. He is father of everything. No? All living entities, all material energy, as if you discover something, it is called the father of this scientific discovery. So he has discovered everything, material and spiritual, both. Therefore he is the original father of everyone, not only of the living entities, but also stones, woods, earth, water, fire, everything he has created. Bhumi rapana lobayu khang mano buddhiri. Prakriti me astadha, bhinna prakriti me astadha in the Bhagavad Gita. So he has created everything. He is actually the father. But out of love, the devotees, they accept the father as son to give more service. Father is obliged to give service to the son. He has given birth, therefore he has obligation to maintain the son, to give service. So, here if you accept God as son, then you cannot avoid the obligation of service. In other way, you can avoid. This is compulsory. Therefore, sometimes devotees, they pray, here it is said, prayed for. The sixth incarnation of the Purushar was the son of the sage Atri. He was born in the womb of Anusya, who prayed for an incarnation. She requested that you all three, you become my son. Thank you very much. All glory to you.